first we thought that new theorem was not solved. I don't
Okay,
understand what.
let me try to solve a problem. And okay, see what is Bayes theorem. Bayes theorem is connected to actually total probability and that conditional probability. I'm taking a very simple problem. That problem already we have solved. Okay, so suppose there are three boxes, three identical boxes. Containing white and there are three identical boxes containing white and black balls. Okay, say the first contains three white and four black balls. The second box contains four white and five black balls, and the third box contains five white and four black balls. Okay, so problem is first we are selecting a box at random. Okay, third box contains five white and four black balls. One box is chosen at random and a ball is drawn from it. So we are selecting a box at random and we are choosing a ball from it. We need to find what is the probability that the ball is white What is the probability that the ball is white And secondly, we need to find if the wall is white, comma, what is the probability that the second box was chosen? Okay, so you want to solve this problem. Okay, what is the probability that the second ball box was chosen? Now we'll try to solve this problem, and also we'll try to see the connection of this problem with total probability theorem and the Bayes theorem. Okay, so see the solution. So first, this is the sample space. Now, sample space consists of three. We are having three possibilities. We can select the box one, so that I'm writing as B1, or we can select the box two, and we can select box three. Okay, so at least we are selecting a box. So we'll select either B1 or B2 or B3. One of the box we'll select. Okay, now three boxes are there. First, we are selecting boxes. Okay, so let B1 is the event. B1 is the event of choosing the first box. B2 is the event of choosing the second box, and B3 event of choosing the third box. B3 is the event of choosing the third box. So there are three options. Either we can choose box one or box two or box three. So probability of choosing box one is 1/3, since three options are there and we are selecting one. Probability of box two, P of B3, is equal to 1/3. Now see the events here. The events are mutually exclusive. B1, B2, B3, they are pairwise mutually exclusive. From the diagram, it's very clear. The events B1, B2, B3 are pairwise mutually exclusive, and the union, that is sum of all these sets, is equal to the sample space. Okay, that is B1 union. Certainly occur. Either B1 will occur, or B2 will occur, or B3 will occur. Okay. So this we have selected the first box. Okay. Now, so we are selecting the boxes. Now, second, we are selecting balls from the chosen box. Okay, so there are how many options we are having? We can choose the box one and we are drawing a ball from it. We can choose box two and we can draw a ball from it. Or we can choose box three and we can choose a ball from it. And what kind of ball we are interested in? We are interested in choosing a white ball. Okay. Let W be the event of choosing a white ball. Let W be the event of choosing a white ball. Now, if W is the event of choosing a white ball, so in how many ways we can choose a white ball? Probability of W. Now, there are three options. We can choose box one and we can select a white ball from it. If it's not the case, we can select B2 and we can choose a ball from it, union B3 intersection W. Okay. Now, since B1, how do you know B1, B2, B3, these events are mutually exclusive. Since these events are mutually exclusive, these events are also mutually exclusive. B1 intersection W, B2 intersection W, B3 intersection W, these events are also pairwise mutually exclusive. Since these events are pairwise mutually exclusive, what we can write? Probability B1 B3 intersection W. Okay. Now, so this can be written as, using the definition of conditional probability, what do you know? Probability A intersection B, that can be written as probability of A, probability B condition A. Okay. Now, or sometimes this can also be written as P of B. Okay, just a minute, let me explain with the same kind of notation. Here, probability B1 intersection W. Now see, it's very carefully. B1 intersection W. B1 intersection W. So that can be written as P of B1, P of W condition B1, or that can be written as P of W, P of B1 condition W. Now, which way we should write? Okay. Now, this is the meaning of this means we are first choosing the box, then we are selecting white ball from the box, from the chosen box. But the meaning of this is we are choosing a ball and we are choosing a box from that is given the color of the ball is white. Okay, but here the game is of choosing the ball from the box. So we should write in this way. First we'll choose the box. So that will be P of B1 into P of W condition B1. In that fashion, we should write. So this is P of B1, P of W condition B1 plus P of B2, probability of choosing box 2, into P of choosing a white ball, provided we have selected box 2, or what we can write just a minute plus P of B3 into probability of choosing a white ball from box 3. Okay, so what we'll get here, this will give, this is 1/3 given into, now box 1, total number of ball in box 1, 7, and 3 balls are white. So we are selecting a ball from, okay, a ball from 7 ball. How many ways we can do that? 7C1, and 3 white balls are there. We are selecting a ball from that 3 white ball, that is 3C1. So what we will get? 3 by 7. Total number of points favorable to the event divided by total number of point in the event space, okay, plus 1 by 3. Now in the box 2, P of B2, this again it's 1 by 3. Now box 2 contains 9 balls, 4 are white, so that is 4 by 9. Plus 1 by 3 into five by nine. So 1 by 3 we can take common. So 1 by 7 plus 4 by 9 plus 5 by 9, 1 by 3, 7 into 9. So what we'll get? 9 plus 28 plus 35. So the value is 72 by 8 by 21,
sir.
8 by 21 is coming, right?
Yes, sir.
So 8 by, it's coming 8 by 21, okay? So this is the probability of selecting a white ball, 8 by 21. That's the probability of selecting a white ball. Now, we don't know whether this ball is selected from the first ball or from the second ball, second box, or from the third box. We don't know, okay? So here, we this P of W, this is known as the total probability. This is total probability. Total probability. Now, Now, what we wanted to find, if the ball drawn is white, if the ball is white, that is, we already know that a white ball was drawn, okay? Now, this white ball may come from box 1 or box 2, since we have selected the box at random, okay? So, we may have selected the first box, or we may have selected the second box, or we may have selected the third box. Now, what we want to find now, probability of selecting the second box. Already we know that we have drawn a white ball from the selected box. Okay, so P of B2 condition W. Now this will be given by Bayes' theorem. Now this can be written as, okay, let me show how we can write. Now P of, by definition of conditional probability, we can write B2 intersection W divided by P of W. P of W already we have calculated. Now we need to calculate probability B2 intersection W. Now probability B2 intersection W, that can be written as, since the result P of B2, P of W condition B2 divided by P of W. So this is 1 by 3 into 4 by 9, I think. Let me check. Yes, 4 by 9 divided by 8 by 21. Okay. So if we simplify that, what we'll get? If we simplify and try to find the answer.
Seven by eighteen.
Okay. So that is probability of selecting the second box, provided we already know that the ball is drawn from the selected box is white. So this is known as Bayes' theorem. Okay. Now tell me, what was your confusion?
Actually, sir, I thought, sir, previously, sir, we were using extended version of conditional probability, no, sir? Like, here, sir? Down, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, here, sir, P2 B2 by W, and again used on the second step, you used again another conditional probability, sir. Second step, again you extended this.
This one you're talking about?
You again extended, yes, sir, B2 by W, B2, no, sir. So I thought, sir, why you were
again okay. Using okay, that is, you mean to say, like, this can also be written as P of W, P of
B2
condition W. Okay, but that doesn't make sense here. Okay, since first we are selecting a box. Okay, so we are selecting a box, that is P of B2 into P of W condition B2 will come, okay? First we need to select the box, then we will select a ball from the selected box, okay? And if you are writing this, see this thing, if you are writing in that way, P of W into P of B2, P of W, so this will get cancelled, you will get this equal to this, obviously that's same. Okay, same, that is, you're not getting the value, you're getting the same expression only. P of B2 condition W, again you're getting P2 condition W, okay. let me try to solve another problem. From a box containing from a box containing 10 chips numbered two chips are drawn one after another without from a box containing 10 chips numbered 0, 1, 2 up to 9, two chips are drawn one after another without replacement. Two chips are drawn at random one after another without replacement. Okay. Find the probability that the sum of the numbers find the probability that the sum of the numbers is more than find the probability that the sum of the numbers is more than 10. Find the probability that the sum of the numbers is more than 10. Okay. Now, tell me how we can solve this problem. Now, without replacement means let me write not more than 10. Sum is first, let me sum of the number is 10. This is, let us try to find this one first. Okay. Now, without replacement means we are from the box, we are drawing a chip, we are noting out the number and we are not putting that chief inside the box again, okay, that is without replacement. And with replacement means just we are noting down the number and again we are putting that chief in the box, okay. But that is not here, we are not considering here. We are doing the experiment without replacement. Without replacement means suppose in the first draw, first chance we have selected the chip numbered one, so in the second chance that chip is absent, okay. So that is without replacement, okay. Just tell me how many points are there in the event space. So event space consists of the total number of points in the event space is equal to first drawing we are getting 10 options. Okay, from first drawing we are getting 10 options. Now we are selected a chip. Okay, we are not putting that back in the box. So for the second drawing, how many options we'll get? We'll get 9 options. So total number of points in the event space is 90. Now we are selecting the chip in such a way that the sum is 10. Okay, now when the sum will be 10, what are the points? Okay, now the sum 10 so what will be the points? What will be the sum? See, from the first drawing, suppose we are getting 9. So in the second drawing, we are getting 1. The sum becomes 10. Or in the first drawing, we are getting 1. In the second drawing, we are getting 9. So 1, 9 or 9, 1 or 1, 9. Then first drawing we are getting 8, second we are getting 2 or 2, 8. First drawing we are getting 7, then second drawing 3, 3, 7. First drawing we are getting 4, second 6, 5, 5. So this point will appear only once, since now 5, 5, see, that's not possible, sorry. 5, 5, this will not be possible since in the first drawing, if we are getting 5, now for the second drawing, that chip is absent. So in the second drawing, we cannot get 5. So these are the options. Okay, so how many options are there? How many points are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 points are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is there any other possibility? No other possibility is there. So therefore, the probability of sum 10, so that is number of points favorable to the event 8 divided by total number of points in the event space, 8 by, that is 4 by 45. Okay, so that's the answer, 4 by 45. So please try to solve some more problems. Next class we'll start a random variable.